How does your body turn food into the poop? Mechanical digestion begins in the mouth as the food is chewed. Chemical digestion begins in the mouth when the food mixes with saliva. Saliva contains an enzyme, amylase, that begins the breakdown of carbohydrates. The epiglottis is a flexible flap at the end of the larynx in the throat. It acts as a switch between the larynx and the esophagus to permit air to enter the airway to the lungs and food to pass into the esophagus. The esophagus is a muscular tube connecting the throat with the stomach. The esophagus is about 8 inches long. The esophagus muscle acts with peristaltic action to move swallowed food down to the stomach. The action of peristalsis looks like an ocean wave moving through the muscle. The food then enters the stomach, which is a rounded, hollow, J-shaped organ located between the esophagus and the duodenum. The stomach has 3 mechanical tasks to do. First, the stomach must store the swallowed food in liquid. This requires the muscle of the upper part of the stomach to relax and accept large volumes of swallowed material. The inner layer of the stomach is full of wrinkles, known as rugae. Rugae both allow the stomach to stretch in order to accommodate large meals and help to grip and move food during digestion. The second job is to mix up the food, liquid, with digestive juice produced by the stomach. The lower part of the stomach mixes these materials as a blender by its muscle action and breaks down the food into tiny particles in 3 millimeters. Finally, the stomach empties this acidy mash slowly into the small intestine. The small intestine, or small bowel, is an organ in the gastrointestinal tract where most of the end absorption of nutrients and materials from food takes place. It lies between the stomach and large intestine and receives bile and pancreatic juice through the pancreatic duct to aid in digestion. Duodenum, the first part of the small intestine, which receives partially digested food from the stomach and begins the absorption of nutrients. The duodenum is the shortest segment of the intestine and is about 23 to 28 centimeters, 9 to 11 inches, long. It is roughly horseshoe-shaped. The pancreatic juices and bile that are released into the duodenum help the body to digest fats, carbohydrates, and proteins. The food is in intestine now and have very long way to go. As a person grows, the small intestine increases 20 times in length from about 200 centimeters in a newborn to almost 6 meters in an adult. The inner walls of the small intestine show mucosal folds. These are called the plicae circulares. The plicae are more numerous in the early and reduce in numbers in the later part and are completely absent. Digestion is important because your body needs nutrients from food and drink to work properly and stay healthy. Proteins, fats, carbohydrates, vitamins, minerals, and water are nutrients. Your digestive system breaks nutrients into parts small enough for your body to absorb and use for energy, growth, and cell repair. Proteins break into amino acids. Fats break into fatty acids and glycerol. Carbohydrates break into simple sugars. What is left over, which is mostly liquid, then moves into the colon. In the small bowel, the food particles get even smaller. The food takes the nutrients to other organs in the body. The water is absorbed in the colon, bacteria in the colon break down the remaining material, then the colon moves the leftover material into the rectum. The rectum is like a storage holder for the waste. Muscles in the rectum move the waste, called stool, out of the body through the anus.